Kriint, and welcome to the third episode of Let's Build Diagon. I'm gonna be real and honest with you, this episode is gonna be boring. I'm being real here. So I sat down and I recorded this episode last week, but I decided not to record it because I wasn't really feeling it. Not the episode, I wasn't really in the mood of recording anything. Because I was keep calling the service for my laptop and they were keep telling me that they don't know anything about it and there is no progress, and I was just upset. And I was not in a happy mood to record anything. Because I was just too mad. I was being too mad, and I don't want to bring like negativity, and I don't want to like force myself to be happy for a video, and I don't know, I just didn't want to sit down and record it basically. So I have recorded the exterior part. We basically, and you will see, we'll do the fake like buildings, the London buildings, but we don't end up doing all of them. We basically will do a version of of Leaky Cauldron, and the building next to it. Basically we'll do 1, 2, 3, 4 buildings of this side. Okay, I'm sorry, 4 buildings for this side, like the exterior of 4 buildings, let's get that straight, and I think 1 building on the other side. So we basically cover the 3 buildings that I have done up to now. Three buildings that I've done up to now. And at the end of the video, we're gonna start doing the oldery. But I decided to add that part just so I can get to the 15 minute markup. I recorded the oldery this week, like after I got my laptop back, which, hooray! Yes, I was done and I recorded the oldery, but I decided not to post them together or in one video, and rather splitting them up because I didn't really want to have like a 30 minute video. I know that, man, not everyone wants to sit here for 30 minutes and watch me build stuff. So I tried to make them small. So this is why I told you this part is gonna be boring. We're not gonna do any stops. This is literally what we're gonna do the entire time. Build the exterior of fake buildings. So yeah, it's gonna be boring, but I had to do them. But because I have already recorded the owlery, I'm pretty sure that, yeah, I finished that. There's gonna be an episode next Tuesday, which I usually just post these videos on every Thursday, so we're gonna have one on Tuesday and a regular on Thursday, just so you know, we can get there a bit faster, because that will take probably forever. Also, as you saw, I changed the layout as it was suggested. I definitely prefer it this way. I think it looks way cooler, way nicer, and makes a lot more sense, to be honest with you. Yeah, it looks like a big alley, and I like that, like a continuous road of shops. So yeah, what else? Yeah, that, and I'm gonna record another one, so I'm gonna, basically, you can leave any feedback if you watch this episode. I don't know if you have any feedback, like, if you like the exteriors. There are a few things that I want feedback for, but I feel like not many people are gonna sit and watch this because it's boring. So I'm gonna mention them in this episode, and I'm gonna also mention them in the next episode. So yeah, the owlery, I think it turns out to look good, but I don't know. The thing that I'm not sure about the exterior of these buildings is how they look on the diagonal, like the actual diagonal. I think at least the first building, it looks kinda weird because the exterior of the building is a 3-story building, but the cake shop, what was its name? The sweet shop, I don't recall the name. It is 2 stars, so yeah. This is my only problem. Other than that, I'm in love with it. I think it looks so darn cool. I just really like it. I tried, at least for this side, to mimic as much as possible the buildings that are near Diagonal again. Jeez. Leaky Cauldron, I guess the location the Leaky Cauldron was supposed to be. So yeah, I tried to do that. I don't know, I think I really like them. So yeah, what else? There was something else that I wanna mention about it. I don't recall. So these shops are straight up like just a two-tile shop, like they have nothing on the inside. I painted, and you will see it a bit later, the interior black, so you won't be able to see anything. So yeah, my only problem, and I'm gonna be completely honest with you, is when I loaded this on my boyfriend's laptop to record, like, you know, this episode, I recalled how horrible it is to having to load something that is completely big. Because when I did Hogsmeade, everything was fine when we're in the build menu. Like, I had no problems loading it and making changes. But when the time came for me to load it with Sims and to actually play test it and to take screenshots and do the cinematic, I realized how big the lot, not the lot size, like how heavy of items, like of data, I guess, that Sims had to load for this specific build was. So that means that I had extreme trouble, like, making Hogsmeade load when I tried to move many Sims there, and that didn't work at all. When I tried to, like, make Sims come, they tend to disappear or not work properly. And that was because we had a lot of, like, details and stuff, which I loved. I do want to do that again. But it was horrible, and I know that not everyone has the perfect computer or laptop to play games, and a lot of people play it in the lowest settings, so downloading Hogsmeade must made them feel like even horrible, like few of them might not even be able to load it at all. Like, for example, I had to record the cinematic on 720 and not 180, as I usually do for everything. So, and why I'm saying all of these things is because I think that if we do Diagonally and Nocturnally in the same lot, this is gonna be an even bigger problem. Like, imagine we did 22 shops, as I recall. I'm sorry. If I do recall actually correctly, I'm not completely sure, I think it's 22 shops. So here, there are gonna be even more shops, with even more details, because it's a bigger, it's a bigger lot. Okay, sorry, I hope that wasn't too loud. Yeah. Because it's a bigger lot, and there are more shops, and they're, like, they have even more details. So I decided to separate Diagonally with Nocturnally, in different lots. And it's not because I don't want them to be in the same lot, it is because I think it's necessary. This is the only way. I know that they will look for sure better if they are in the same lot, and it makes way more sense. And few people might say I do this to get, like, more downloads, like, people tend to say or even think these things, but this is not the case. Like, I just want a nice experience. So yeah, I think we're gonna get this lot and move it. And as I am seeing it right now, this, like, the exterior of it fits only in one place, as of the maps, I guess, the neighborhoods we currently have. And this is only Magnolia Promenade, the one with the four lots that came with Get to Work. And I don't think it actually matches anywhere else, because they are big tall buildings, you know, like an actual like city, and all the other are like small neighborhoods. So I'm thinking to either move this one in a lot over there, or to get again, this is not gonna stay here, or get again this lot and move it to the get together, like, what was its name? Windenberg. Or move it to Windenberg, where we've done... God damn it. Lake Cauldron. I don't know, I keep saying it diagonally. That's why I phrased there. And move it there. But, because the God damn it. See, I don't know why. Because the Leaky Cauldron, we did it as of an old village and based it on, like, a template, a miniature. They're completely different styles, so they don't match. The one that we did, like, the Leaky Cauldron, totally matches the Windenberg feel. But it doesn't really match the Diagon Alley feel that I'm going for. So, I'm thinking that I will have to redo Leaky Cauldron, but I don't know in which city, I guess, I have to do it. Like, I think I will probably move it, to be completely honest with you. I think I'm gonna probably move the thing, like this lot and Leaky Cauldron to... God damn it. Magnolia Promenade? I don't recall. And there will be also Nocturne Alley. I don't know if there is there any other shop we can do there? I don't know. So yeah, these are the things that I want, basically your feedback. As I previously said, I don't know if people are gonna watch this till the end. So I'm gonna mention it in the next episode too, but I'm probably... Oh god. Sorry, but I'm probably gonna move it to get to the get together word or the get to work lot word. So one of these, and sadly we will have to separate Nocturne Alley with Diagon Alley. So here is like the Olery shop, something like that. Ilops, I think it was Ilops Owls Emporium? I don't recall. Yeah, I don't remember here. So yeah, but you will only see the exterior. You will see the exterior and how it forms in the other episode, because I didn't want to make it like a 30 minute long episode, plus I wouldn't have anything to say in 30 minutes episode. I usually tend to blab in 30 minutes, and people don't really want to hear me blab about random stuff, so try to keep it like on point. Yeah, these things, just try to explain you. I based it a lot from how it looks on Lego. Of course, I base everything from what I have on Harry Potter Lego, so that's a good thing. So yeah, on the exterior it had like few hanging cages for owls and like two stands that owls could actually sit on. So I tried to kind of mimic that. I don't know. Well, I tried at least. And the interior, like the cages, I basically copied and pasted what I've done in the owl post on Hogsmeade. Yeah, you will see that next time. So this is all for this episode. I'm sorry it was a boring one, but thank you so much for watching, and I hope that you will have an amazing day, and take care. Bye.